afternoon, everyone. How's everyone doing? I don't know about you, but I'm very nervous. So let's start by asking you some couple questions. So how many of you have heard of 3D printing before? Please raise your hand. Wow, a lot. I'm sure we have little gifts that are made by 3D printing. How many of you used a 3D printer before? Still a lot. Have you ever heard of bioprinting before? Wow. What if I told you our organs can be printed for transplantation? Every time when people hear that my research is related to bioprinting, the first question that usually comes to me is, if I lost one of my body parts, let's say my ear, can you print one and transplant to me? Someone even asked me, is your ear bioprinted? My friend sometimes jokes around and says, oh, I want to have turkey. Can you print some for me? Well, technically, the answer is yes. We can print any body parts we want. But there's still lots of unsolved challenges to reach the ultimate goal. Fabricating artificial tissues or organs for transplant and saving people's lives. All of my research, including bioprinting, is what we call tissue engineering. Before I explain it, I want to talk about why tissue engineering is important. Currently, the treatment for organ failure is a transplant with healthy tissues or organs. You may wonder, how does organ transplantation work? There's three scenarios. So the first one is very simple. For example, if part of skin is burnt or one of your cardiac vessels is blocked, in this case, the doctors can take part of your healthy tissues or one of your blood vessels for transplant. That's what we call autologous transplantation. And you don't need a donor. But if you have organ failure, which means one or more of your organs, such as kidneys or lungs, stop working, so you need to replace it with a healthy one. And a family member or friend with a matched organ volunteers to donate part of their organs to you. So you can get transplantation as soon as possible. The most common case is when people donate part of one of their kidneys to the patient, like Francia Risa donated one of her kidneys to Selena Gomez. In addition, some parents donated their livers to their children, because the liver can regrow itself after transplantation. But if the organs do not match, you will go through the most long and painful third situation. It's not just physical torture for the patient, but also a mental suffering for the whole family. First, a doctor's referral is required. Then, the healthcare from the professionals and from the transplantation centers and program will evaluate if the candidates are eligible for the transplant. For example, if they're alcoholics, if they overdosed, is there organ failure due to attempted suicide, their health, age, social contribution, and many other factors will all be considered to evaluate if the candidates are eligible. Here, I want to show some numbers. Last year, 2023, there are over 23,000 people donated their organs in the US, which led to over 46,000 people the transplantations. That's almost the population in Binghamton. But can you imagine how many people are in the waiting list for transplantation? No guess? over 103,000. And the number is still increasing. So that means even everyone in Binghamton donated their organs, it's still way too far. Every 10 minutes, there will be a new patient adding to the waiting list, and 17 people die each day while waiting on the transplant list. Recently, I watched a medical series called The Resident. It's a pretty good show, by the way. Spoiler alert, for me, the most touching part is when one of the main characters, Nick, had a brain death from a car accident. The doctors persuaded her husband to shut down her life-managed equipment. They said Nick was signed up to be an organ donor, and she will save 8 people's lives. Several years later, another patient was sent to the hospital, and they found that that patient had Nick's heart transplanted. At the end of that episode, Nick's husband brought their daughter to the patient room. He put a stethoscope on their daughter's ear and said, "That's mom's heart." After watching that, I had a phone call with my mom. Sorry. Talking about how I want to deal with my body when I die. Surprisingly, both of us has the plan to donate all of our usable organs for transplantation. For me, donate my organs is a continuity of my life, and my family can remember me in another way. I'm sorry, I'm too emotional. Okay, so getting transplantation is just the beginning. The transplant can fail during or after transplantation. Has anyone here heard of watched Modern Family before? Yeah, it's pretty popular. Sarah Hyland, who acted as Hailey Dunphy in that show, has been struggling with kidney disease since childhood. After receiving a kidney transplant from her father, her kidney failed after several years, and she had to take the second transplantation after that, and she needed to take anti-rejection medicines regularly and struggling from the depression for many years. Because of the severity of this problem, we start to question, what if we can have the organs that have exactly the same cells as the patient? With this medical breakthrough, there'll be no possibility of organ rejection. That was the start of tissue engineering. If you ask ChatGPT what is tissue engineering, it will reply you, "Oh, tissue engineering is a multidisciplinary field that combines with engineering, biology, material science, and to create functional biological tissues or organs," or something like that, because that's the answer I got from it. But I'm not here to give you a biological lecture and talk about how cells grow, proliferate, vascularization, blah, blah, blah. It's weekend, it's not Monday. Let's start by imagining you're going to build a house. Maybe a tiny house for my newly adopted dog. So the first step is to design the house. By imagining how does it look like? What's the structure of it? After that, we can start to build the house. The second step is to select the materials. You need to consider if it's toxic or not. Is it suitable for a dog who likes to chew things? I'm definitely sure the cardboard is not a good idea. After that is our third step. So we need to connect them. You want to connect them with cement or just using nails and hammers. So during the whole building process, you also need to consider if the house is suitable for a dog to live in, while keeping in mind the construction time and budget. So the whole building process is similar to fabricating artificial tissues or organs. The first step is to design a model that replicates patient's organ. Then we need to select biocompatible materials so that the cells can attach, grow, proliferate onto it, and can be biodegraded gradually. Then the third step is to consider what kind of techniques we are going to use, such as 3D printing or bioprinting. Although tissue engineering seems out of reach, it is quietly changing the world. In 2017, my grandmother was diagnosed with a coronary heart disease, and she needed to replace with two of her valves. The doctors gave us two options, mechanical valve or biological valve. At that time, I never heard of biological valve. I have no idea what it was. In fact, I didn't even get a chance to make the decision because I'm too young at that time. The doctor said the mechanical valve is usually made by the metal and carbon, and it needs to be replaced after 15 years of transplantation. Considering of my grandmother's age, she would be over 80 years old at that time. So we don't want her to take the second surgery to take the risks. And the biological valves are made by the lining of the car's heart that was fashioned into a valve and can be replaced after several years without a surgery. So we selected the biological valve for replacement. Now, 7 years have passed, and my grandmother lives happily and healthily without taking any anti-rejection medicines. This is an example to show the huge potential of tissue engineering. When I started my research, I became very excited because by wearing a lab coat and gloves and playing with different chemicals and bottles like scientists, and become extremely excited whenever I have some good results and achievement. My first project is to fabricating artificial capillary vessels. So our capillary vessels can be classified into three groups: arteries, veins, or capillaries. The diameter of arteries and veins ranges from 5 to 20 millimeters. So it can be fabricated with some simple method like injection molding. But the diameter of capillary vessels ranges from 5 to 10 micrometers. That's around 1/10 of our hair. So it is difficult to fabricate those tiny structures. And we introduced another technique called electrospinning. Electrospinning allows us to fabricate ultra-fine fibers that usually ranges from micro to nano level. The electrospin microtubes can be utilized for various research. For example, the photo on the right is a figure of the cell culture image of microtubes. Those green highlights are the live cells. It shows the cells can attach, grow along the microtubes. That means the microtubes can be a great substitute for capillary vessels. In another project, we broke down those microtubes and mixed them with hydrogel for bioprinting. It shows that the embedded microtubes can improve the cell attachment and may lead them for differentiate and form new blood vessels. And to create more complex structures, we also combined 3D printed sacrificial materials with the hydrogels from casting and can obtain various structures for cell culture. Although we're just at the very beginning of it, those results show a great potential for the future. Tissue engineering was only developed for 40 years and still have a long way to go. We developed and introduced various techniques to fabricate artificial tissues. Researchers used 3D printers to print artificial bones for bone regeneration. Bioprinter was used to print soft tissues like artificial skin or cartilage. Electrospinning was used to mimic human vessels or ligaments or tendon. And 4D printing was introduced that began a new era that involved the time in the processing. To date, we have successfully fabricated artificial blood vessels, and I can't wait for the day when the first bioprinted organs printed comes out. I hope you are as excited as me. Thank you.